Well, it is Christmas, and even as we say those words, all those childhood memories, the feelings, the goosebumps, and the giggles, they all come flooding back to our hearts and minds, just like they did last year and all the years before. Every December 1st, it starts all over again. To some, it means presents and mistletoe, and to others, it means shopping malls, candy canes, favorite carols, and Christmas cards. Once again, the hearts of the young and old are filled with joy and hope, for we know that the event we celebrate, the birth of Christ, has forever changed the destiny of all mankind. Today we rejoice. We celebrate his birth. Let us rejoice, for he came to us.
Thank you.
Well, today we do rejoice, for the Lord has come, and we can sing with all of our hearts, joy to the world. Christmas is here, and as quickly as it came, this season will soon pass. And once again, our children will be asking, Daddy, how much longer until Christmas? And then the waiting will begin all over again. In the days before the birth of Christ, the people of the tiny Jewish nation grew more and more hopeless as the years passed and their long-promised Messiah did not come. Had Yahweh, their God, forsaken them? Did he see their suffering, their pain? Why did he not come as he had promised? Could they continue to believe that he would come, that he would help them? The waiting seemed endless as one conqueror after another plundered the land, as the tyranny of the Roman government now beat upon the back of this suffering, broken nation. Their song turned to mourning, and their hearts were filled with doubt and despair. And yet, through the darkness, came a promise, a glimmer of light to warm their wounded spirits. Behold, a virgin shall conceive, and you shall call his name Emmanuel.
When all Israel was troubled and their hearts were filled with fear, God sent Isaiah to the king to assure them he was near. And so they would believe his words, he gave to them a sign. A virgin will conceive a child who will be of God's design.
Oh,
is the great Emmanuel.
Call his name Emmanuel. God has come with us to dwell. Now we know all is well, for Jesus is
Oh,
When you're oppressed, you like the sound of the word Savior. Emmanuel, God with us, is reassuring. The promise of his coming lived in the hearts of all of Israel. His promise was the theme of their songs, the songs of Zion. He would be their conqueror to save them from their oppression. He would be their Messiah, their deliverer, their king to rule from the throne of David. And his coming would be the reason for great joy.
Of history, who will rise up and conquer our dreaded enemies. He'll change our destiny, and we will all be free.
That little Judean town of Bethlehem was bustling that winter's night with travelers jostling for a place to stay so that they could register for yet another Roman tax. The prophet Micah had spoke of this insignificant town, "But you, Bethlehem, though you be small, out of you will come one who will rule Israel." That cold winter's night, on a hillside above the town, a band of shepherds huddled around a small fire. The crackling flames did little to warm the chill that had settled in around their hearts. For their hearts were breaking, and their hope was almost gone. One lonely shepherd looked into the black night sky. How could a God so very far away understand the pain in his heart? As he looked down on the town, his hatred burned towards those Romans who had controlled their lives. O Yahweh, we long to be free. How we need you.
sense a stirring in the flock tonight. I don't know what is wrong, but I must keep each one inside. And my heart can't be still with all the restlessness within. I don't know just how long before my freedom will begin. Could it be Messiah will soon come to reign and free me from all of my pain and let me know peace once again? He's the one my heart is so longing to see. I wonder how long it will be. Oh, it seems I hear the crying of the lambs. I must hasten now to tend the flock again.
Suddenly an angel appeared unto them with a message of hope. A Savior has been born in Bethlehem. So they went into Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the newborn babe, wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger, just as the angel had told them. They looked at the face of the child and saw before them the very fulfillment of the promise of God. Mary knew that this night was a night of wonder, and her heart was filled with praise to the God who had come as their Savior. For although she couldn't understand all he was asking of her, this young virgin mother chose to obey. The angel Gabriel had come to Mary from God. You are highly favored. The Lord is with you. You shall conceive and bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall be called the Son of God. For with God nothing is impossible. And Mary answered,
My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. For he that is mighty hath done unto me great things, and holy is his name.
Let's just sing it together without the music.
Praise you
from your heart, let my my life give you praise. Let my life bring glory to you, Jesus. Not just the song, Lord, I sing, but God, the way I live my life, let it please you, Jesus. Let it honor you, God. Thank you, Lord, for the example that we see today, God, of your love and of your mercy. Jesus, we worship.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east, and we have come to worship him."
The star glows brighter than the other stars up in the sky. I don't know what it is, but I believe it is a sign. Let us go, we will follow, though it leads us many miles. We will go, maybe it will lead us to that holy child. Could it be a king has been born to the Jews? I wonder if it could be true. He'll reign, they'll rejoice at the news. He's the one their hearts are so longing to see. And I wonder just where he will be. Oh, the star has come to rest in Bethlehem. We must hasten to that place where it now stands.
King Herod was deeply disturbed by their questions about the King of the Jews and puzzled by the brilliant star which the wise men followed.
The wind blows, I can sense a stirring in the land tonight. I don't know what is wrong, but I'm convinced all is not right. What's that star? That one shining in the distance, bright and fair. I don't know what it is, but I'm uneasy with it there. Prophets told of him. I wonder if it could be true. He'll take my throne and then he'll reign. They'll rejoice at the news. Yes, they'll rejoice at the news.
He's the one
that
their hearts are so longing to see. I wonder just where.
I cannot let this happen. I'll find a way to stop it.
Seems I found a place in Bethlehem.
I must never let this child become a man.
Foolish, foolish Herod. The wise men had no sooner left the palace of Herod than they once again saw the star and followed it to where the Christ child lay. The time had now come for the plan of salvation to unfold. For unto us a child is given, unto us a son is born, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, and Jesus is his name.
Light. For there is born in the city of David a child who will drive out the night, and the government shall be on his shoulders, and his kingdom will never end. The great King of all the ages, and even a child will call him Bread, and he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. He shall be called Everlasting Father, and his kingdom will not cease. He shall be called Emmanuel, God with us, King of Counselor and my God and my Father, and when I'm troubled, he's my Prince of Peace, and when I just speak the name of Jesus, I find everything that I need, and now he is my Wonderful Counselor, my
Yes, a son is given, and Jesus is his name, for he shall save his people from their sins. God in his mercy heard the cry of the brokenhearted and came himself to meet their need. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. The Creator became like the created, that we might know him. For those who are longing for new life, those who are lonely, hurting, searching for peace, the tyranny that rules our hearts is our need for the Savior. But the question that keeps many from him is, can a God in heaven understand my pain, my despair? Yes, he understands. He cares, for he too felt hurt, rejection, and betrayal. You are not alone. He understands. For you, he came.
How a God who made the sun to shine, who made the sound of thunder, and set each planet in the sky, could ever know just how it felt to hurt. Sometimes even cry, to often feel rejected, then be left to wonder why. And so he came to us, he took on flesh, and he came.
He would understand. is not complete till I accept your love for me and let you come inside my heart to
been to remind us that even as Jesus came gently years ago knocking on our heart's door, still today he is here this morning and knocking on every heart that is in this building. I'm sure that there are folks here today that there have been things that have kept you from opening your heart to him. But I'm going to invite you as we sing this chorus again to just sing it, not just words and music, but sing it from your heart and tell him, Lord, I want to open my heart to you. I want you to live in me. I want you to make a difference in my life. Would you help us? Everybody join and sing us. Sing with us.
Come.
Right now we're going to sing the last section of this, but you can help us because we've already in a sense taught you several of the choruses that are here, and some of them you already know. And this one that opens the ending is praise you, praise you. How many of you would say amen? Let my life, O Lord, praise you. Lift a hand and just say, Lord, let my life praise you.
Hey, hey, hey.
Everybody lift your voice and sing.
Praise you.
Let my life.
Let my life.
Lift your hand as you sing at this time.
Praise you. Praise you.
Let my life.
Let my life. Praise you. Praise you. Praise you.
Let my life. Say, let my life, O Lord,
let my life, O Lord, praise you.
Because he came to us, we have hope and we have joy. This song says, let us rejoice and be glad. Everybody sing, let us rejoice and sing.
Let us rejoice.
Big hand clap offering.